We are the Supremes, a literally cultured read aloud, written by Zoe Tucker and illustrated by Salini Perera. Mary was excited. Today was the high school talent show, and she couldn't wait to sing. During her performance, she sang her heart out. Mary loved music, and being on stage was such a thrill. Mary watched the other performers. Florence was up next. She had the sweetest voice Mary had ever heard. After the show, Mary and Flo walked home together. They both lived on the east side of Detroit in a big community called the Brewster Douglas Housing Project. The people who lived there were like one big family, and everyone looked after each other. The girls' friendship grew as they spent all their time together, singing along to records and practicing their dance moves. One day, we'll be the best girl group in the world. One day, Flo and Mary heard about an all-male group called the Primes who were looking for an all-girl group to sing with. They decided to audition. Another girl who lived across the street auditioned too. Her name was Diana. Together, they were sensational. You girls are just perfect primates. They became the Primettes, the newest girl group on the block. Being together was great fun, and they each brought something special to the group. Flo was strong and clever. Mary was fun and bubbly. And Diana was friendly and confident. Soon, the Primettes began performing at local parties and clubs. Detroit was famous for its big car factories, not to mention its cool music scene. The girls always dressed to impress the movers and shakers of Motor City. Sometimes they sang with the fourth singer, first a girl called Betty, and then later a girl called Barbara. But Mary, Flo, and Diana were the heart and soul of the group. They rocked and bopped at sock hops all over town. A sock hop is just what it sounds like, a dance where people kicked off their shoes and danced and hopped around in their socks. The girls sounded so good, a friend suggested they audition for Motown Records, the most famous record company in the whole city. Hey, you girls sound amazing. At the time, black musicians didn't have the same opportunities and rights as white musicians. It was very frustrating and unfair. But Motown Records was a black-owned record company that was very successful. They were helping lots of black musicians become pop stars. It was a big deal. The manager of Motown was a man called Barry Gordy. He found the sharpest, coolest, funkiest artists in town. He was tough, but he knew his stuff. Mary, Flo, and Diana were desperate to be part of the scene. Okay, let's do this. At the audition, with hearts hammering and butterflies in their stomachs, they sang their favorite song. Berry Gordy loved their sound, but he said no. He thought the girls were too young and they needed to finish high school first. They felt really sad and frustrated, but it made them even more determined to succeed. He can't be that great if he can't see how good we are. For the next year, the girls worked really hard. They finished their schoolwork and practiced their music. Mary taught them new dance moves, and Flo made sure they were all in perfect harmony. Diana designed and made all their outfits. And together, they became stronger and more polished than ever before. Finally, their hard work paid off. In 1961, Berry Gordy signed them to Motown Records, but only on one condition, that they choose a new name. All the different names were mixed up, and Flo was given the tricky task of picking. She chose The Supremes. But Diana and Mary hated the new name, and the three girls had a big fight. That doesn't sound like a girl group at all. Ugh, it's ugly. Then they realized their shared dream was much more important than their silly squabble, and they quickly made up, as all good friends do. Before long, the Supremes became superstars. They performed all over America, and their music was played and loved all over the world and beyond. Their first number one hit, Where Did Our Love Go?, was played to the crew of Gemini 5 as they orbited the Earth. The Supremes became much more than the best girl group in the world. They became a symbol of the changing times in America, and people of all colors and nationalities idolized them. It's amazing what you can do with your friends.